So guys, just about to head into the exclusive media call for Pippin in Sydney at Lyric Theatre. Pippin's a difficult show to describe, so I'm going to do my best. I actually had the chance of seeing the show with the principal cast in New York on Broadway, and it was sensational, completely took me by surprise. It follows a story of a young prince whose name is Pippin, and he's the son of King Charlemagne. And he's coming back from studies, I think it is, and he is completely lost and trying to find his sense of purpose. He's just completely at a crossroads and doesn't really know what to do with his life, which is kind of an interesting concept considering what's happened in 2020 this year. I'm sure everyone's feeling a bit of a sense of loss and uncertainty and had their kind of struggles. This show's perfect for that. It's about finding your sense of purpose and what really works for you. Even though it follows that story, the show all plays out under the roof of the circus tent. So it's a circus troupe essentially retelling the story. Now, as you'd expect, because it's a circus show, not quite the greatest showman, but you've got lots of acrobatics, you've got magic, you've got knife throwing, and then you've obviously got your classic Broadway dancing and musical numbers. It's kind of a cross between a Cirque du Soleil show, a Vegas acrobatic magic show, and your classic kind of Broadway show, but a very high quality one at that. Definitely worthwhile seeing, considering I saw it with the principal cast. It was amazing, and I'd actually say it's probably one of the best shows I've actually seen on Broadway, and that's saying something. I've actually seen quite a few. Interestingly, with Sydney at the moment, we're going to have got Pippin that's about to start playing now, then you're going to have Frozen in December, and then you're going to also have Hamilton coming out in March, which takes over after Pippin at the Lyric Theatre. Now, I might say something controversial here. I actually think, in my opinion, that Pippin is the best show out of the three, and I have seen them all. Pippin is just a standout. Just the choreography is better, the set pieces, and also the musical numbers. There's at least about seven decent songs in here, or at the very least six. The other shows, I don't think even get that close to that number. The soundtrack's great, and the composition's great. It was written by Stephen Schwartz, who was most famous for his work with Godspell, and also Wicked, which most people know and actually liked quite a bit. We're just about to head in, and hopefully I can report some good things to you guys.
Good afternoon. Welcome to Pippin. It's gone into the roof. Welcome to Pippin. The cast will preset on stage behind me. We're going to get through this, my bit particularly. That's the fun bit. We're going to start today with Magic to Do, which is the opening of the show. So if I can invite our wonderful company to the stage. I will introduce the magical company of Pippin. Thank you.
Thank you. and Pippin made a promise.
I promise not to waste my life on commonplace, ordinary pursuits. I am going to live a life that's extraordinary. I know that there is something
fulfilling. Something completely fulfilling.
Something completely fulfilling. And I am going to find it. I don't exactly know what I want to do or where I want to go. But everything has its season. Everything has its time. Show me a reason and I'll soon show you a rhyme. Cats fit on the windowsill. Children fit in the snow. Why do I feel I don't fit in anywhere I go? Rivers belong where they can ramble. Eagles belong where they can fly. I've got to be where my spirit can run free. Gotta find my corner of the sky. Don't you see, I want my life to be something more than all. Rivers belong where they can ramble. Eagles belong where they can fly. I've got to be where my spirit can run free. Gotta find my corner of the sky.
Welcome to Sydney.
Hi, thanks so much.
Now, how are you liking it so far?
I love it. I love it here. Beautiful weather, beautiful people. Can't complain.
This show, Pippin, I've been really waiting for it to come. Like, I had the privilege of seeing it with the principal cast in 2013 on Broadway with Patina Miller.
And
how much of Patina Miller's performance influenced how you did? Because there's lots of crazy acrobatics that you've got to do. You got hula hoops, you got, you know, hanging.
Yeah.
How's it all been doing all that work?
Well, luckily, when I joined the Broadway cast, I understudied her. So I got to really learn from her, and she really became a mentor to me and really took me under her wing. And so I was just watching her every night. So I think a lot of her stuff kind of naturally went into me.
Osmosis, yeah.
You know, it's just, you just can't help it. When you're watching someone every night and you have to do it, you're just going to naturally take on a lot of their characteristics. But it's been really nice doing it now because I've been away from it for so many years. And I've never had a real rehearsal process, like a long rehearsal process with a new cast. So I've really been able to come into my own and really make it my own leading player, which has been really gratifying.
The lead player is quite an elusive character. How would you best describe it? Because Pippin's kind of a hard show to describe, really. So how would you best describe lead player?
Technically, she's the leader of this troupe, and she's the ringmaster. She's the boss. She's in charge. But she's a very complex character, and I think it's very up to anybody's interpretation, kind of how they want to see her. She's kind of like the voice in Pippin's head, but she's also a strong woman, and she's also androgynous, and you know, she has so many opposites within her, which I think is really cool to play. She's light, she's dark, and she's masculine, she's feminine. And she really runs the gamut, I feel, of the human experience. And she's very complex.
Yeah, such an androgynous character, and especially from the 70s, obviously it was a male character.
Yeah.
They did change it to female. I actually think it works better as the female with the revival.
How have you taken that into consideration? Did you use some of the 70s stuff, and did you use...
I in the beginning I watched a lot of Ben Vereen's videos because he was just incredible in it. And I loved what he was doing, I loved what Tina did, but I feel that it doesn't really matter if you're a man or a woman doing this role. I think it's really about the characteristics and embodying that leader and just that kind of manic energy. And that's what's so cool about this role is that anybody can step into it, like no matter gender or anything like that.
It's interesting because even though it's Pippin, it is kind of your show really in a way, because you are the ringmaster and you're kind of directing traffic a lot
really
of the time.
You've kind of created everything, which actually when I think about it more in that sense, it kind of takes the pressure off. Because I'm like, well, if anything goes wrong, I'm like, I decided to do that.
Yeah, like, absolutely.
I created everything, which kind of like takes the pressure off overall. But yeah, it's a big responsibility, but it's the most fulfilling experience I've ever had.
I've seen quite a few shows on Broadway. The unique thing about Pippin is that there is so many good songs, and there's kind of like those, it's that jazzy kind of funky vibe in it. Unlike anything else I've really seen, it really took me by surprise. And you know, I think I had like Neil in front of me, like when I was watching it, and it was celebrities would come out to watch it. It was just had this kind of consistent audience that came in. What's your favorite song in the show? Because you do have quite a few nice ones.
Yeah, a lot of great songs. My favorite song to listen to is probably Morning Glow, because I just think it's so beautiful.
Yeah.
But my favorite song to sing would definitely be On the Right Track.
Right.
It's just so jazzy and. So much great dancing in it. It's just the perfect musical theater number because it has full acting, full singing, full dancing. It's like a full story in one number. But I love that song. The music is so amazing because they all have just different vibes, from like jazz to funk to kind of folky. There's just so much going on.
How do you balance all the choreography? Because obviously you've got the incredible dance and then you've got, you know, all the acrobatic stuff, and then obviously you have to be pretty much pitch perfect, you know, hanging upside down and that kind of thing. How have you found that kind of balance?
It's hard. It's hard, and kind of the only thing you can do is just repetition. It's just stamina, and like the more and more you do it, then the easier and easier it gets.
And probably last but not least, from memory, I think Simple Joys does have you kind of singing up pretty much most of the song with a hula hoop, you are hanging for one of your kind of songs as well. What's harder, hanging upside down singing or hula hoop?
I don't have to sing when I'm on the trapeze. If I had to sing on the trapeze, that would be harder. But hula hooping is actually not that bad.
Hula hooping is not too bad?
Yeah.
Well, break the leg. Good luck with the show.
And
hopefully, you know, great success.
Great, thank you.
No worries. Thank you very much.
Hey guys, just got out of the media call for Pippin in Sydney at the Lyric Theatre. So far so good. Production looks great, the acrobatics look great, the song and dance is looking good too. I will say that it's not quite up to the standard that I saw with the principal cast on Broadway, but I don't know if they're holding back for the show or what. But yeah, it's pretty hard to compete with the principal cast of a Broadway show. That's you know, the top echelon and standard that you can get. Sydney doesn't always get that. One thing I will say though, standout is Gabrielle McClinton, who plays the lead player, who's pretty much the lead female role in the show. She looks phenomenal. Also, Ainsley Mellum, who plays Pippin, he's quite good too. If you don't know, he actually played the lead role in Aladdin at the Capitol Theatre a while back, and I think they even actually took him to Broadway. I didn't really like him in that show. I didn't think he was as good, didn't really suit him that well, didn't really suit the show that well, I don't think. This show actually is suits him quite well. I think it's quite a bit better. So they're the two standouts, but Gabrielle McClinton definitely is the one to look out for. If you do intend to see it, you're going to have to be masked up and socially distanced, but that's to be expected in the current climate. But otherwise, I would try to get your tickets soon if you do want to attend this. By the time the show starts getting some buzz, they're going to be already trying to get Hamilton set up for March, so you might not be able to get any tickets. And I think it will get some buzz, at least, you know, sometime into December. So hopefully you enjoy the footage. Until next time, stay safe, and I'll catch you guys later. See you the next one.